A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 13th July, on the front page you have ISRO's lunar touchdown has dry run on soil fetched from Tamil Nadu. So Chandrayaan 2's lander and rover were tested on a simulated surface. So dry runs have been conducted. We have discussed in news earlier, the Chandrayaan 2 mission is going to be launched on July 15th. So dry runs are taking place here. You can see the details provided to regarding the orbiter, the lander, which has been named Vikram, and the rover, which has been named Pragyan. So it will be launched on JSLV MK3. Then next is Supreme Court tells Speaker to defer call on Karnataka MLAs. So court orders status quo and schedules hearing. So now the Supreme Court is going to hear the matter on the Karnataka MLAs who have submitted their resignation to the Speaker. The Supreme Court has told the Speaker to delay the call on these MLAs. Then this is IIP dips to 3.1% in May owing to slowdown. So this is index of industrial production. So its figures for May 2019 is 3.1%, where in April 2013 it was 4.32% growth in index of industrial production. Also retail inflation figures are given, CPI, that is CPI has quickened marginally. This is figures for June. So in May 2019, retail inflation was 3.05% and now it has marginally quickened in June 2019 to 3.18%. So these are official figures. Then below you have Pakistan asks India to pull back fighter jets. So Pakistan has actually extended the airspace ban which was there. We had seen how in airspace ban for Indian commercial flights has been announced by Pakistan since February 26, 2019, after the Indian Air Force fighter jet struck Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorist training camp in Balakot after the Pulwama terror attack. So since then, the airspace has been blocked by Pakistan for Indian commercial flights. So now this ban was going to end on July 12, but it has further been extended for the fifth time till July 26. And Pakistan has told India that it will not open its airspace for commercial flights until Indian Air Force fighter jets are removed from forward air bases. And this is Kiran Bedi asked to move division bench first. So Supreme Court has disposed a petition filed by Puducherry Lieutenant Governor Kiran Bedi for clarity on the issue of control over bureaucrats in the wake of a turf war which is going on. We have been discussing this quite often between the Lieutenant Governor and the Chief Minister of Union Territory of Puducherry. So Puducherry and Delhi are two union territories, Delhi being a national capital territory too, which have a Lieutenant Governor who has powers, plus also there is an elected government. So that raises some conflicts. So in Puducherry also there is a turf war between Lieutenant Governor and the Chief Minister over control over bureaucrats. So the Puducherry Lieutenant Governor has approached the Supreme Court, but Supreme Court has disposed of the petition and asked her to move division bench first. So she's supposed to first move a High Court's division bench. So division bench of Madras High Court. Here you can see that Lieutenant Governor had directly appealed in the Supreme Court against the decision of a single bench of the Madras High Court. So first, after the single bench judgment, the Lieutenant Governor should move a division bench of the High Court and then approach the Supreme Court. And this is Chinese men unfurl banner near line of actual control. So at least 11 men in civilian clothing, you know, close to the line of actual control. So in Jammu and Kashmir region, we have LOC, line of control, wherein India and Pakistan occupied Kashmir get separated, and on the other side, right side, you have LAC, line of actual control, in Jammu and Kashmir's Ladakh's region, where the region beyond that in Jammu and Kashmir lies with China. It's the Chinese side. So recently this incident occurred where 11 men in civilian clothing drove close to the line of actual control, and they unfold a big banner apparently to counter Dalai Lama's birthday celebrations in nearby village on this side. This is what happened. It's occurred at Dhimchok village in Jammu and Kashmir. And then this is another incident. Madrasa students thrashed in UP for not chanting Jai Shri Ram. So FIR has been registered against four persons in this Unnao incident in Uttar Pradesh. Then on page 3 below you have Supreme Court to decide on NGT's power to take so much of permissions. So the Supreme Court has agreed to examine a legal question whether the National Green Tribunal established in 2010 to deal with cases pertaining to environmental issues has the power to take cognizance of a matter on its own. That is suo motu cognizance. So Supreme Court bench is going to look into this matter and decide on the issue. So till date, NGT took suo motu cognizance or whenever needed. On page 4 you have Delhi Development Authority told to pay 50 lakh for failing to curb pollution. So this is National Green Tribunal which has directed Delhi Development Authority to deposit 50 lakh as performance guarantee over the urban body's failure to curb pollution on the Yamuna floodplain. And below you have Haryana told to deposit 20 crores in escrow account. So National Green Tribunal has recorded incapacity of authorities in dealing with legacy waste. So this amount has to be deposited. And this it goes to the Central Pollution Control Board's account. So this is because it did not ensure compliance with the solid waste management rules of 2016. The scientific disposal of waste is to be done under the rules, but that has not been done by Haryana authority. And that is why it has been asked to deposit its money in escrow account. And if it fails to comply with the measures, then the amount will be forfeited. Then on page 6 you have floods hit 8.6 lakh in Assam. So 9 people have been reportedly died due to acute encephalitis syndrome and Japanese encephalitis. And the total death toll is around 165 since January in Assam, where floods have occurred. So here you can see the rivers of southern Assam's Barak Valley have joined those in the Brahmaputra Valley and are flowing above danger mark. So it is said much of the damage has been done due to Brahmaputra and 7 of its tributaries. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is aftershocks in Goa. So this is regarding how MLAs in Goa have also defected to BJP. So by aiding defections, it is said the BJP is shrinking opposition space in an unseemly fashion. So we saw the crisis in Karnataka and that triggered even a crisis in Goa. When MLAs are shifting allegiance from Congress to BJP. And this is the climax. So this says India fell at the last 4 stage. The cricket will now have a new World Cup winner. So this is regarding ICC Cricket World Cup. And the lead article is a case of confused thinking. So this is regarding draft national education policy. The article says that it lacks the very ability it emphasizes, critical thinking and deep understanding. So various provisions under it are criticized, the language being emphasized on 3 language formula, so all those issues are picked up. And it is India-centric study education system which has been emphasized on. And this is game of chicken that can end in disaster. So this is regarding confrontation between USA and Iran in West Asia. So the article says it could snowball with damaging economic consequences. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have Ground Zero coverage, where today the coverage is on death by digital exclusion. So this says many in Jharkhand have been denied food under the public distribution system as their ration cards have been cancelled in a mad rush for putting in place a digital system. So activists claim that some have died from starvation. Government denies this. So this is problem created by Aadhaar. That since it's not Aadhaar enabled, they are digitally excluded. PDS system does not provide them with food, and this is the case in Jharkhand. Then on page 12 you have railways cannot be privatized, says Goel, but it will invite investments for new technology. So this is clarification being given when public-private partnership has been spoken of on for railways in the budget. He says that railways will not be privatized, but private sector will be brought in, investment will be brought in for new technology. And this is government in a spot over bill seeking quota in Rajya Sabha. So this is a bill which has been introduced in the Rajya Sabha. So this is a bill introduced by YSR Congress MP Vijay Sai Reddy. It's a private member's bill. It seeks reservation for OBCs in Rajya Sabha and the assemblies on the lines of reservation available for SC and ST. Then below you have Vikram lander tested over Challakere craters. So this is regarding Chandrayaan-2, the lander on moon surface which India is going to send. So it has been tested over Challakere craters. This has been taking place earlier too. So this is Bengaluru test facility which simulates lunar surface. Then on page 13 you have India-Pakistan officials to meet at Wagah for talks on Kartarpur. So India and Pakistan have stopped cooperation on all aspects, but Kartarpur corridor is one aspect on which India is keen to move ahead. So the modalities to bridge the gap in the corridor project will be discussed at this meet now. And this is India-Russia discussed space cooperation. So possibilities for production of space systems in India are being explored in this India-Russia discussions. And this is India-US teams hold trade talks on trade ties. So India-US teams have discussed on ways to improve trade relations. We have seen tense trade relations between India and USA recently. And this is evidence gathered from social media secures conviction in Khalistani case. So India collects proofs from WhatsApp and Facebook servers in USA and got conviction in this case. And this is India again abstains at UN vote, draws criticism. So this is regarding India abstaining at the vote for extending the mandate of an important UN official who reports on violence and discrimination against sexual minorities. So this India has again abstained from voting. It did not vote it in favor of this UN official reporting on violence discrimination against sexual minorities, though Supreme Court has scrapped Section 377 of IPC in India. Then, so this is regarding LGBTQ community. So Section 377 criminalized LGBTQ community, that is lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, queer community, but Supreme Court struck down this section. And this is NHRC notice on custodial deaths. So NHRC has issued notice to Tamil Nadu and Uttarakhand governments in separate cases of custodial deaths from suicide. On international page, you have Turkey defies US as S-400 arrives. So Turkey will face American sanctions and may be expelled from the F-35 program of USA too. NATO has also raised concerns, but Turkey has taken the delivery of S-400 missile defense system from Russia, which USA had not has said had said that it should not, otherwise under the CATSA Act of USA, countering American adversaries through Sanctions Act, the sanctions would be imposed on Turkey. But Turkey still went ahead. And this is China to impose sanctions on US firms for Taiwan arms sales. This is the $2.2 billion deal between USA and Taiwan. And China says this violates international law and it has imposed sanctions on US firms for this deal. And this is Russia's top missile system has many buyers. So this is regarding the S-400 missile defense system. So Russian army has begun using the S-400 missile defense system designed to intercept and shoot down any threat from the sky in 2007. So and it has been using it since 2007, and now dozens of S-400s have already been deployed throughout Russia, from the country's most western point in Kaliningrad to its far eastern corners too. And four S-400s are also stationed in Crimea, the Black Sea Peninsula annexed by Russia from Ukraine in 2014, who have been deployed to Syria, and where Mexico has intervened, in favor of the regime, the Bashar al-Assad regime. And also, it has now started selling it. China was the first country to buy the weapon from Russia, the S-400s. India has also bought five S-400 systems for $5.2 billion. Delivery is due by the end of next year in India. We saw how it has been delivered in Turkey, even Qatar, Saudi Arabia, Iraq are other countries which have shown interest in S-400. Then below you have US will consider 301 probe on India, says trade official. So this is Section 301 of the US Trade Act of 1974. So what this calls for is you can see here that a probe will take place. It is a probe which will be a precursor to tariffs and other trade measures which can be issued against a country. So this is with respect to India. So if the trade issue between the USA and India is not resolved quickly, then it is said that the US will consider 301 investigation. So this is Section 301 of US Trade Act of 1974. Then here you have new constitution calls Kim head of state instead of supreme leader. So this is a move which is seen as a step towards US peace treaty. So Kim Jong-un will now be called head of state and not the supreme leader of North Korea. Then there's no important news on the business page. And on the last page you have, warming threatens Greenland's archaeological site, says study. So these are changes in soil characteristics which affect organic elements which are ruining the Viking settlements here in Greenland. The archaeological products here, like archaeological site in Greenland, as you can see, a bone point is shown here, and these are now being threatened because of climate change and changes in soil characteristics. And this is Google to probe leak of private conversations. So Google has said that it will conduct an internal review after it discovered confidential audio has been leaked by a contractor of private conversations with its digital assistant. So the US has acknowledged misconduct in the leak of the Dutch language conversations by one of its language experts contracted to help refine its Google Assistant, the artificial intelligence powered system for voice interactions. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Thank you.